An update on Tropical Storm Nadine and Hurricane Miriam. Hurricane Miriam's in the eastern Pacific, Tropical Storm Nadine's in the northeast Atlantic. Let's take a look at Nadine first. Nadine holding its own 65-70 mile per hour wind gusts. This storm is completing its loop. It's moving away from the Canary Islands now, away from Morocco. It doesn't look like it's going to head in that direction. It's going to continue towards the west, and eventually now models shift it further south. So this thing is really teasing the Azores. We're going to wait and see. This thing is moving so slow, it's hard to say whether this is going to affect the Azores or not, but heavy surf is going to continue along the southern portions of the Azores. This system is going to bend back, and eventually we think a trough, this trough across the western Atlantic, will eventually make its way and pull Nadine up in it the next couple of days, or actually out towards a week. Let's look at the satellite picture of Nadine quick. You can see Nadine here, very sporadic. It's completing its loop. It's not very impressive, but it's got that central core, which is, you can see some of the spiraling bands in the infrared showing some of the oranges and reds, so that's good enough for a tropical system. Now we have, in the eastern Pacific here, we've got Miriam. Miriam now is a Category 3 hurricane with 120 mile per hour winds. This system really means business as it moves towards the northwest. It's not going to affect any land immediately, but it'll eventually impact the Baja California. And this will actually make landfall as probably a weak tropical storm or strong tropical depression, 35 to 40 mile per hour winds. Now let's take a look at the satellite picture of this storm. This storm looks amazing. Look at the visible satellite picture. Here it's just really, you can see that really tight eye. This system really wound up. We take a look at the infrared. Very, very nice core colors. You can see wrapping around this system very well and very impressive. But it's pretty much reached its peak and will continue towards the northwest and eventually towards the northeast, towards Baja California, during the next 4 to 5 days. Now let's take a look at stateside weather in southern Canada and North America. We've got this front, which is going to push Nadine out. Stalled front across South Florida. You can see there's some showers in the Keys. And we've got this warm front that's draping and pushing some showers across Nebraska and northeast Kansas. Also, we've got a trough diving down into the Rocky Mountains here, and this is producing some showers. And the northwest here, we have a cold front, but once again, it's dry, so that much-needed rainfall you need is not on its way. You can see some systems diving down across the Great Lakes, too, and these will produce showers, but not looking at anything major. Precipitation model shows very little in the way of activity, possibly across the Ohio Valley, the next days 2 and 3, which would be possibly Thursday and Friday. But other than that, there is not a whole lot going on. In fact, you can see the west clear, the central pretty much clear, and the east coast pretty much clear. There's not much to talk about other than the tropics. I'm meteorologist Mark Molnar from MeteoMark.com. Like us on Facebook to the right. Subscribe to us above. Don't forget to like this video if you liked it. Post a comment below. We're very interested if you have questions. We'll have a question and answer video eventually. For MeteoMark.com,